Moving into the house was really a challenge in the beginning because it was totally unlivable. The kitchen has carried years and years of use.
Like 70 years worth of like
grease
and dust and dirt.
This came with the house. It's an oven range, and the whole entire unit gets hot when you use it. So when Stark's in here, I can't have him near this because he just touches it and he can burn himself.
There were bugs everywhere. We had an ant and spider infestation. This is a live spider. Yeah, so that's
that's
a pretty
that's a regular occurrence.
We hired our contractor to come and help us with the house. We renovated the master bathroom. We bought all new windows in all of the 3 bedrooms and the living room. We did all new flooring in all the 3 bedrooms. We were quoted initially that it was gonna run about $20,000, but as we got weekly bills, I was realizing that we were very quickly surpassing that 20 grand mark and we still weren't finished.
All in, we'd spend $45,000, and the state of the house is unfinished, unsettled. It's not a kid-friendly environment, and it looms over us like a cloud. Lauren is cooking in the kitchen with no visibility of Stark or the living room. The second phase of the project is the center of the home.
We started interviewing other contractors, but it's been difficult finding someone who can do it in a quick timeline. Everyone's been saying, oh, it could take 5-6 months to just make the house habitable.
And so that would be disaster because we're
about 4 months away till the baby's born.
Yep.
We can't live in a construction zone.
So I think that we should actually take this wall where those 2 doors are currently and bring it all the way out and extend the house so that this is an entire line and we have a complete square here.
So then if we were to bring this out, would you be open to doing a retractable glass wall in this entire corner? So that's just this huge corner of light that
100%.
Brings down. So we have to get rid of the wall that divides the kitchen from the living room at the bare minimum. Essentially, if this wall goes out and this corner of the home is extended, and then this entire area could be the kitchen.
The real thing that I'm struggling with is I really don't want to give them an island. If we give them an island here, there's absolutely no place that we're going to be able to introduce any type of dining area.
Right.
With 2 kids, they're not going to have a dining table.
If we position sort of like a farm table or something like that in the center, they have an opportunity to eat here, but also use this as prep or to serve.
Especially if we're giving her all this entire perimeter wall of countertop space.
Let's talk about some design finishes.
Okay.
Dun-da-da-da! Shiplap. What do you think?
Babe, you really want to do shiplap, huh?
I do want to do shiplap because I
want to be Joanna Gaines.
Look at me. I'm in a denim jacket. I'm going to talk like this.
You're not sensible enough to be Joanna Gaines.
I'm really not.
I'm open to it. I like the texture of it. We'd keep it painted white, I assume.
Yeah.
So our palette is going to be light white, warm cream colors, maybe grays, putties, really soft, everything that has like kind of a coastal twist to it.
Yeah. In terms of design tone to share with Lauren and George, I feel like obviously they're beach people. They live near the beach. They bought that house because it's sort of a beach bungalow. She feels a little bit modern to me. He likes things with character, with age.
Yeah.
So it's something like modern beach farm.
Modern beach barn. Because you're doing the shiplap, we're coming up with this whole rustic elements. Maybe there's like old furniture kind of mixed in.
Yeah, we really want Lauren and George to pick the stone that's got the most movement, that's got the most veining, that's got the most depth.
Warmth.
Yeah, it's just integral to the kitchen because the whole kitchen is bright white and we really want that contrast.
But at the end of the day, we can only take them so far. The rest is up to them.
George is super stressed out, by the way.
George is so
stressed out. I don't know.
He's got his hand in his mouth.
I don't know what to do.
I know.
I think we have 2 options. Which
one
would
you
guys do?
All right, so what do you love most about the porcelain slab versus the quartzite?
This one, I think, has a lot of character to it, and I want to like that.
Yeah.
I would like to feel really good kind of committing to that, but I think that one is something that we will love forever.
The good thing about the porcelain slab is that it's massively durable. I mean, it's obviously waterproof, and it's great for indoor-outdoor.
I think I'm really leaning that one. I think that one might make a little more sense.
All right. Okay, I'm done.
I think you guys have made a great decision.
And it's half the price.
It is half the price.
Oh. You are saving us money and making decisions.
Yay! Are you nervous?
Yeah, I'm feeling insanely nervous. We are so ready to get back home. We're very, very excited to get into the house.
I cannot wait
to see it.
I'm so anxious.
Cute.
Okay.
All right, they should be here any minute, you know that, right?
Yeah, let's go inside and we will, let's finish everything up.
What if I start giving birth?
Don't.
Just kidding.
Don't start giving birth. I think that's the one thing that we can't do. I don't think we have any idea what to expect.
No, I have no idea. I don't know what modern beach barn is gonna look like.
There could be farm animals in there for all we know.
Where do I put this?
I think it should go on their dining table.
All right, this is locked. I'll get this, you get the locks.
Oh my God, look at the front door.
What? Babe.
Yeah.
They're here.
Get the scrim.
Guys, we need the scrim.
Here we go. This door already looks amazing.
Okay. Just a second, guys.
We're almost ready for you.
Okay.
All right, guys, come on in.
Oh my God. Oh my
God. Oh my God.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Wow.
Oh my God. Like.
This looks too good.
How is this possible?
This looks too good. Look at this chair. That chair looks incredible. Awesome. That looks incredible.
This is crazy.
Oh my God.
Welcome home.
Oh man. Oh my God.
This is
Oh, yeah, we're just getting started.
Did you believe this?
I know.
I can't believe this.
Look at you.
I can't even believe this. I want to live here.
You do.
Guess what? As of today, you do. And you get to come home.
I cannot get over what this looks like.
This is my personal gift to you guys.
Yeah. No.
Yeah. I've had that for 15 years.
It was the first vintage piece of furniture he ever bought.
But I thought it'd be nice. You guys are entering into a new chapter and it's perfect timing. So.
We are gonna love that. I'm crazy about it because it has such a personality to it.
You know, one of the things that you brought us into the house for initially was the fact that that kitchen was just brutal.
Yeah.
And the dream for this house was always like, open it up.
Are you still stressed about the table?
I was worried
about it?
I don't know if I can handle it.
I know.
You know, this is what we walked into. This is what it looked like when we met you. And what's behind that is hopefully a bigger dream for you two than you even dreamt of for yourselves. We hope that you're excited as we are to show it to you.
Yeah.
Okay.
You ready?
Oh
yes, we're all ready.
Drop it.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. What is this? Look at this space.
This is beautiful. Oh my gosh.
What? How did you even do this? Oh my God.
You guys can walk
in. Go in.
Okay. This is so cool.
I can't even believe this. Is this the porcelain?
That's the one you guys picked out.
I actually think I might pass out. I have to like take a second here.
Do you want to sit down?
I kind of want to sit down.
You can sit down at your dining table.
So this is, you know, kitchen central. You can prep on this. You can have meals on this. Oh. You can pull the high chair up to this.
Oh, and it's like perfect height.
Yeah. And look at your counter space.
I mean.
So you've got all this workspace now.
There's so much. That was my biggest concern. Yeah. I think it was a good decision not to do the kitchen island because I think it's so inviting. It's just naturally like, come and sit at our table. And I can't wait to host like Thanksgiving. It'll, if you want to, it'll be great. George, look at the lamps in the tree.
No way.
Okay. Oh my God.
And there's a counter outside.
There's your ledge. There's also bar stools on the other side.
Oh my gosh.
No.
You want to have coffee? Let me just open up the door for you.
What? This is like a resort.
So this has all been redone. There's modern elements architecturally mixed in with things that just have a lot of charm.
Oh my God.